If you fake had showed Chadwick Boseman this much love when he was alive, he would have had a bigger career. Now stop overdoing it and go find someone that's alive to support. Run along now. What's up, everybody? Tyra Vera here, the absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world. Before we get started, I want you guys to do me a favor. Like the video. Please do it. It really does help me out. Subscribe if this is your first time watching, or if you haven't subscribed yet, and also make sure you comment. You know I'm gonna get on your nerves with what we're talking about, so let's get to it. Okay, so what I just said at the beginning was actually a tweet that I put out yesterday when everybody was putting out their RIP tweets for Chadwick Boseman, but not everybody has to agree with me, and that's what it is. If anybody's not familiar, Chadwick Boseman, Black Panther was his most famous role. He was a very talented actor, so that's why if you noticed nothing in what I just said was saying that he wasn't a talented actor. I was just saying that people should have shown that level of reverence when he was actually alive if they really felt the way that they were pretending to feel on social media. That's all I was saying. People are welcome to have their feelings on it, but it's not something I'm gonna apologize for, and it's not something I feel bad about, and I don't feel like I was at all out of line. So my friend Niles Abston, he chimed in. If you guys aren't familiar with Niles, you can check him out on Twitter at Niles100 is his handle on Twitter. And it turns out Niles Abston really is a fan of Chadwick Boseman, which I didn't question that at all when he told me he was a fan, but he's also an actor. So in a lot of cases, you know, like actors do pay attention to other actors. But one thing I didn't like about the way he went at it with me was there was a point where he was like, oh, so you're calling black people fake. And like, I know some of you maybe don't know exactly what I'm like on social media or exactly what I'm like in life for that matter, but really, if I wanted to say that I thought black people specifically were being fake, then I just would have started the tweet off with, hey, black people, stop being fake. But that's not the way I went at it because that's not the way I felt. What I was talking about was everybody, people of all different races, people in general were just acting like this was this huge loss for them, which if it was, then you definitely didn't show it in life, because I don't remember anybody ever saying, I'm gonna go see the new Chadwick Boseman movie. I never saw anybody say anything even remotely like that. People liked Black Panther, that did really well, but that's a Marvel movie. They're all big like that. So for me, it's about actually showing support for people when they're alive. And then Toni Braxton ended up posting something that was much more eloquent later on. She posted something like, give people their flowers while they're here, which was basically the same sentiment, like show people you appreciate them while they're still alive. And that's really what I'm saying. Like, you know, Chadwick Boseman was a successful actor. I'm not trying to take that away from him. I'm not trying to pretend he wasn't. But at the same time, he wasn't like a Tom Cruise. He wasn't like a Brad Pitt. He wasn't like a Mel Gibson back in the day. He wasn't even like a Michael B. Jordan, really. Like, he was great and he made a lot of money. But not a lot of people were mentioning Chadwick Boseman. So that's why I called people out for being fake. It was just people in general being fake. Which, you know, I don't understand why people send so many RIP tweets anyway. I mean, like, do you think Chadwick Boseman is in heaven spending his first couple hours scrolling through tweets like, oh, thoughts and prayers from Marge? Or do you think that God's gonna actually read the tweets and be like, hey, this Chadwick Boseman guy really seems to be a VIP. Let's make sure he gets in the pearly gates right away. No waiting in the line for Chadwick Boseman. Front of the line, directly to me. In a lot of cases, they're really just trying to kind of toot their own horn and be like, I'm such a good person. Look at me. I'm acknowledging the death of this celebrity. Everybody check me out. Like, that's what it seems like. It just seems like people are trying to make it about them. Which, speaking of making it about them, people got mad at Omari Hardwick. Omari Hardwick is an actor from Power. He plays a drug dealer. I'm not sure the name of the character because I've never seen Power in my life. I just found out about this because my East Coast bestie hit me up and was like, did you see they're dragging Omari Hardwick? And I was like, who's Omari Hardwick? And then I decided to Google it and I checked it out and I was like, oh, okay. Because Omari Hardwick had posted something where it was like, I was proud to be your biggest competition. And it was a picture of himself, Omari Hardwick, accepting an NAACP Image Award. And he shared an exchange that he had had with Chadwick Boseman that night when he was on his way up to accept his award. And then people started acting like that was in some way him making it about himself, Which I guess maybe you could take it that way, but like I said, I feel like anybody that acknowledges the death of a celebrity is kind of making it about themselves. Because otherwise, you could just have a quiet prayer. Like, nobody has to be around or see that you're grieving or feeling that way. It really is about you saying, this is the way that person touched my life. So, if that's the way Omari Hardwick expresses his, I don't know why that makes him such a terrible person. So this woman reminds Omari Hardwick that he plays a drug dealer and that Chadwick Boseman played some of the most influential black figures, and because he had played James Brown, and in 42 he played Jackie Robinson, and then also obviously playing Black Panther. So then Omari Hardwick clapped back and told that woman that called him out that she was a cancer, and sort of like what Chadwick dealt with at the end. Then people got on him for that because they were like, you know, thought it was insensitive. Well, hitting somebody when they're grieving like that is insensitive, because you on Twitter, see, this is where I'll make the distinction. People on Twitter and social media in general talking about Chadwick Boseman is one thing. Great, he affected you in some way. You may have had feelings for him or liked him in some indirect sort of way, but you didn't actually know him. But you're now dealing with somebody that actually knew him in real life, but you're shaming that person for the way that they expressed themselves or the story that they brought up or the picture that they used. But, you know, in a lot of cases, straight men in general are just starting to get comfortable with actually being able to express or show the softer side of themselves, especially men of color. You know, like if you're black or brown, in a lot of cases, we're not raised to show a lot of emotion that way. So when you have Omari Hardwick actually opening up and being like, hey, this is the way I felt about it, and then you treat him like he said that he was going to fuck Chadwick Boseman's wife, kidnap his kids, and raise them as his own. I mean, like, that's not even close to what he said. All he said was that, you know, he was proud to be his biggest competition. You know, you don't know what Omari Hardwick and Chadwick Boseman's relationship was. They were both actors, so who knows? You know, the way that Hollywood works is on types in a lot of cases. So maybe every time somebody asked for a black man of certain specifications, that was a role that they'd both end up going in for, and they'd sit in lobbies together. Or, you know, you never know what people's experiences are, especially on the personal level. Maybe Omari Hardwick has a special appreciation for Chadwick Boseman because Chadwick Boseman had mentioned that when he was working on General Hospital, he didn't like that he had to play to some stereotypes. So he had mentioned that to the higher ups at General Hospital, and then he ended up losing his job. And now Omari Hardwick actually plays drug dealers, and maybe he had a respect for how strong you have to be to even say that. Because in a lot of cases in Hollywood, you just have to take what you're given. And here you are, some stranger on Twitter that's decided that you've got to turn this into some kind of thing where he's got to be dragged. It's like, why? Do you have to ruin everything? So maybe I do think you're a cancer at that point. Like, what? Did you get tired of shitting on Terry Crews for a day? Cardi B isn't doing anything? Like, I don't know what point exactly you think you're making by dragging Omari Hardwick over what could have been, like I said, just somebody not knowing how to express vulnerability and trying to do it to the best of their ability. And instead, they kind of mess up. But to drag somebody over that, to me, that doesn't really make sense. I mean, if you're pretending to really love Chadwick Boseman this much, and Chadwick Boseman was obviously a positive person from everything I've seen and read, don't you have a responsibility as a Chadwick Boseman fan, as a person that's pretending to actually care so much that Chadwick Boseman died, as a person that's pretending to actually care about Chadwick Boseman's memory, to actually do something that might be in the spirit of Chadwick Boseman? So maybe try uplifting somebody instead of tearing anybody down. Do you think Chadwick Boseman would actually want you to tear down his friend? I mean, like, does it always have to be somebody that you're tearing down anyway? I mean, like, that's one of the worst things about Twitter. And that's why I stand by the fact that I think people in general are fake. Because rather than honor somebody's memory by doing something that's in the vein of what they would have wanted done or the way that they are, instead you think that the best way to go at it is to drag somebody. So to me, that's where people fall apart. Like, me putting out my stupid tweet to, in general, people that are being fake and trying to make it about themselves, that's something different than people shaming someone at a point that might have been the most vulnerable that they could actually be. Anyway, this has been Ty Rivera. The absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world.